Hi, I'm Alex Dunn, Senior Software Engineer here at Pico UK. I wanted to introduce to you DeepMeasure. It's a new feature in PicoScope 6. And I want to talk to you today mainly about the benefits of using DeepMeasure, in that it's powerful, it's going to save you a lot of time. And I also want to quickly talk about the applications for when to best use it. So let's get started. Let's open up PicoScope 6 and we'll start capturing some waveforms. So this is the demo board we're going to be using today. It's streaming a serial signal, and the line we're going to be sniffing is the frequent anomaly line. Okay, so we've opened up PicoScope 6 and we've got our data stream coming through here. I'm just going to stop the capture and we'll zoom in on our data a bit more. Let's take a look. Let's go to the zoom tool. So let's zoom into around about this area here. And we can see that we've got a very repeatable signal coming through. We've got a short pulse, a medium pulse, and another short pulse. And what we want to do is we want to be able to identify that all of those three signals, all of those three pulses, are as repeatable as they should be. We're going to verify that they appear in the same order for the lifetime of our waveform buffer. So the best way to do that is to use DeepMeasure. So I'll close down the zoom overview. And DeepMeasure is available through the measurements menu, and it's a menu item in there. So I'll click on DeepMeasure. So let's create a DeepMeasure analysis tool. So we'll click on channel A. That's the data line that we want to view. It calculates our threshold hysteresis for us, and we don't need to give it a name, and we can just click OK and OK again, and it'll add a table for us. So it starts to analyze every single pulse that is within this signal, and it populates it in a table in this DeepMeasure window here. And here we go. It took about 10 seconds, but here it is. So if we order by cycle number, then we can see that we've got 375,000 cycles within our waveform buffer. That's a heck of a lot of cycles. And you can see actually that it's a very repeatable pattern. We've got 200 nanoseconds, 1.1 microseconds, 300 nanoseconds. These are all cycle times, and they're very repeatable. So that order stays consistent throughout all of those rows, or we believe it's all of those rows. If indeed we try to find that data anomaly, all we need to do is order by cycle time. And we can see instantly that we've got some cycle times that deviate from those three we just discussed. So let's double click on the first item in the list, and that'll pan and zoom to a particular signal area for us. And we just zoom out slightly, we can see that we found our data anomaly within the trace. That's our needle in the haystack. So you are able to export this data table through this export button here. If I click on that, it gives you the option of being able to export the data to CSV file format, so you can analyze the data within programs such as MATLAB or Microsoft Excel. Well, I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. To download the latest version of software and for more information on DeepMeasure, please visit our website.